this channel. I've been meaning to do a whisper only video for quite a while, and I thought that with the recent influx of subscribers, I may as well go ahead and... If you deleted your homework the day before it was... That's not very whispery, Mr. Bennett. I'm sorry, but we're gonna have to turn off the subtitles. As well as his audio. So, if you did not see the first episode of this series, I made it almost to the top, apparently. Or at least pretty close. Only to be greeted by a simple mismovement of the hammer, which led to the unfortunate fall of my hammer-wielding compatriot to the bottom of the... Oh, gosh darn it. Of climbing. I mean, I went to the very, very bottom. Like, to the point where I could go and drown myself, which I promptly did out of frustration. A link to that will be in the description below, where the thumbnail is my descent into madness. So, this is one of my... Oh, I'm sorry, I'm slowly resorting. This is one of my problematic areas where I seem to have a lot of problems with climbing. Whispering is really hard for me because I'm so used to doing soft speaking, simply because it's much easier to do compared to whispering constantly. You kind of need like a lot of practice for it, and I tend to avoid whispering my mouth out really quickly. So, but without further ado, I'm gonna do it anyways. So, I've always had a lot of problem with these lampposts, but what you guys don't know is that there was actually 3 failed attempts to make a second video of this. And when I say failed, I mean it turned into not very ASMR language, such as death threats toward the potted compatriot that we have wielding the hammer, as well as the occasional smacking of the hand and voice raising. I realized that those were not very ASMR-like of me, so it was better that I just deleted the videos than uploaded them as was. But as you can see, compared to last episode, the mistakes of my past have added up and become a very smooth and... Oh, shoot. Well, anyways, mostly smooth, you know, learned path to the top. And I've gotten a little better at navigating with this hammer at the high sensitivity that my mouse has. If you are new and never heard this before, but my mouse has a resting sensitivity of 16,000 dpi, and that is how I normally use the mouse. It's very rare for me to turn it down to 12,000 dpi. I usually only do that when I have to do meticulous work with small objects, but right now I am currently operating at a grand total of 16,000 dpi. This was mostly done as a joke at first, because one of my buddies said that having 16,000 dpi was never going to be needed. So I set my mouse to that to show him otherwise. And I actually really like being able to quickly move my mouse across the screen at any moment. So since then, it has become the norm. This part's a little difficult, but easy if you know the trick for it, which is just to kind of grapple right there and proceed to move forward slowly. So, thankfully, this appears not to be the case. Oh no, 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 no. Please, no. Let's not play this game. There we go. Kind of, doing that triangle-style jump that you do in retro games to complete this action. Oh, shoot. So, I wanted to apologize for the lack of quality in some of my more recent uploads, specifically Minecraft episode 30 and Subnautica episode 9. I've been dealing and still dealing with some family drama, which involves my crazy grandmother getting back into town, and she has ascended from her mountain dwelling back into the city. Which is causing a lot of unforeseen family drama, and it is causing everyone a lot more grief than it really should be. But that's what she does best, is cause grief. If you don't know what I'm talking about, I would like to refer to you to Skyrim episode 4, where I go into a full detailed rant about this figure in my life and the interesting things she has done and said over my lifetime, as well as what she does and what she... You have got to be kidding me. Okay, that's not actually that bad. But let's not get too frustrated. It's not really that far of a fall down from grace. We can easily get back up. This is simple. We got this. Got this. This is easy. So, anyways, I'll go into the grandma stuff and probably one of the upcoming Skyrim episodes or Minecraft episodes and what's currently going on, because it's becoming more and more ridiculous now that she's in town for the winter holidays. So, That may not sound like a bad thing, but keep in mind, I had work at 5:30 a.m. the next morning. So, while I could always just not do the upload, these videos are sort of therapeutic for me in a sense. I just enjoy doing them. So, also, I don't want to disappoint you guys by not uploading. So, there's also that. And consistency is key. Oops, this is not good. That's my fault, because my mouse got caught. Because recently the wireless functionality of it broke. And because it's a Logitech G902 Chaos Spectrum, it has the secondary backup wired functionality. So I'm currently running on wired, and it got tangled there. So that's my bad. Anyways, not a big deal, because this area is not super difficult to complete. Or repeat, for that matter. We swing this hammer around with great ease, in particular, and boy, my hand is sweaty. I like the word crisp with that popping P at the end. Ooh. Oh shoot, no. Bad Mr. Hammerman. You've been a bad boy. Santa's not gonna be very happy with you this Christmas. You're not gonna get a new hammer for Christmas. Instead, you're gonna get a shovel so you can dig your own grave. Push. Oh no. Yes, there we go. Look at that. No. We got it. It's all good. No, you little jerk. Don't you dare slide down on me. I will end you. So, the secret project that I have in the works right now is being delayed due to my grandmother, but thankfully I have the entire upcoming weekend to work on it freely with no interruptions. So I'm looking forward to that. Hey, look, it's a painting of Diogenes down there. That's kind of cool. I never noticed that before. But anyways, this upcoming weekend I'll be able to work on both the intro and the upcoming project. And I won't have to worry about the interruptions of family drama, which I did not foresee coming, because my grandmother always arrives unannounced and never tells anyone when she's coming. This has led to my mother being under a lot of stress due to prior conditions of her life. I don't know if I've talked about that or not. I don't think I will for a while, just because it's a very personal matter, and I try to kind of keep that stuff, the super personal stuff, out of these videos. So, we finally made it back up here. I think it took a lot longer than it should have. But here we go. It was actually right up here where I made that mistake. swing it around and aim for bandits, catching peepers or building structures. Never doing tons of repetitive minute movements with my hand. I don't know why I'm holding my keyboard. There's really no point to doing that considering this is a single-handed game. If only I was as coordinated with my right hand as I was my left hand, then I could switch my mouse over to being a left-handed mouse quite easily with a simple click of a button, and it would go into left-handed mode. While I do use my left hand sometimes for mouse work in repetitive things like Netflix or whatnot, just when I'm lazy and not wanting to adjust my body for doing mouse work with the right hand when I'm relaxing, I kind of just like, you know, use the left hand because the mouse allows me to. Or when I'm like playing a game that requires use of the arrow keys, that's when I also really do it. Like for example, flash games. That's a really good example when I have to use the arrow keys in the left-handed mouse. Shoot, you little plebiscite. There we go. You know, I really should not use plebiscite because it's not an insult. It's like an official document, so it doesn't really work in the way I'm intending it to. But no matter. It gets the point across quite nicely. If you guys enjoy this whispered style, the soft-spoken, let me know, and I'll do both whispered and soft-spoken more often, because while soft-spoken is more natural and more genuine, I understand that whispered is also a really, really big trigger for some people. Personally, though, I'm more of a soft-spoken person, just because I enjoy the genuine connection with people that it provides over whispering, but whispering also provides those nice tingles. Soft-spoken cannot, which is a huge benefit. So now we're at this really weird part here where I gotta like gently swing the hammer. This is getting a little aggravated, but at least on the bright side, I'm only having to repeat this section. So, it could be much, 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 much worse. And thankfully, I'm getting more used to completing this area with each time that I have to pass through it, finding new little tips and tricks for me to use with each upcoming pass and go through the mountain. To solve problems, new ways to find solutions. I don't know why there's so much like dirt particles coming off of this couch. They should really clean their couches more often, because that's really disgusting. That would drive me up the wall if my couch was like that. Like, oh, my mouse is at its end there. I need to readjust it, because it's reaching that point where I can't like do good motions with it again. So let me pull the mouse real fast. There we go. Oh, that was almost bad. There we go. And now we're just gonna... No. There we go, right there. And then we're just gonna gently pop it. No, you little imbecile. See, as I get aggravated, the insults start to come out for some reason, but they're like, you know, ridiculous. Ugh, I'm trying to adjust my mouse. Chill. Adjusting my mouse earlier did more harm than good. want to do. Stupid pillow. Why are you in the way? Why is there a pillow on my desk? This is stupid and ridiculous. Hold on. Okay. Let me just adjust this. Oh, that's not good. There we go. My mouse cord got caught underneath my laptop. So that's why I was having a hard time pulling it, because rather than freely moving back and forth, the cord got trapped. So downwards motion was becoming more and more difficult with each movement. But thankfully, we're back up here. Back to our spot. There we go. I usually edit the... I just been soft-spoken there. I usually edit the fan noise out of the videos, but on these kinds of videos, if you guys would like the background whir of my laptop's fans as sort of a sleep aid, let me know and I'll keep them in. Especially, they might be in, though. It depends on how much the audio gets distorted in the long run, because removing the fan noise does disturb the audio quality a little bit, and soft speaking helps reduce that amount. Although, yes, oh my gosh, I've made it this far before. Right here is where I made that big mistake last time. Okay, come on. Just gotta take it easy. Just gotta take it slow. Oh no, that stupid thumb is set there. No! That thumb is set up so it catches your hammer. Ugh. Bennett, you sly dog. You caught me monologuing. Oh, shoot. That was a mistake on my part. Thankfully, I didn't catch the slide, though. Because if you catch the slide, it's game over. This is a new spot for me. I don't know how I pulled that off, but cool. Sick motion. Look at that. I am MLG Pro. Gaze upon my epicness as I demolish all that stands before me. Watch as I'm bragging and ranting about how amazing I am. I throw myself off the cliff like a lemming. Shoot. And it happened. I'm not used to doing constant whispering, so I keep occasionally reverting to soft-spoken. I'm really sorry about that. I know this is supposed to be whisper-only. Hopefully y'all forgive me for that discrepancy, but soft-spoken is sort of my trait, I guess you could say. I guess it's half of... Some of this is also probably could be labeled as unintelligible muttering, too. So that's kind of nice, I guess. Oh, the downside is I'll have to edit my video tags from being soft-spoken to whispering, and that's extra work on my part. So, see what I do for you guys. Okay, so probably what's going to happen is after the next fail, this video here. So I'll try to not fail knowing me, that's going to be any second now, and I don't really have too much control over when I do and do not fail. Although what I must say, though, is that whisper raging is a lot of fun. I don't know if you guys are having as much fun with it, considering how much aggression is being poured out into my voice, but I mean, it is a little. Said that I would stop, but I don't want to. Okay, let's just keep going, and hook and sinker. Something that I lack in every video is a hook. Start with that same, hey everyone, it's me, Mario. I don't start like that, but I don't know what happened there. I said it's me, and then my brain's like, oh, it's a me, Mario. Let's do that, because that'll be funny. We're so funny. Okay, now I'm just getting obnoxious, I'm sorry. I tend to go on these tabloid rants when things don't go in my favor. Much like this security camera, it's not in my favor, it's recording my fails, yet somehow it's bolted in strong enough to support a man in an odd cast iron pot. Then again, we don't know if he has legs or not. Chances are they're dead legs, though, much like Joe Swanson from Family Guy. Dead legs. Something for you, Peter. My wife Bonnie is over here, and she's wondering if you'd be okay with me using your barbecue for the next few days, Peter. That was probably the worst whispered impression of Joe Swanson I could have ever done in my entire life. Yet, it happened, so please deal with it. One of my friends from high school could do a really good Joe Swanson. He would do it all the time. He could also do Shaggy, and that was pretty funny because he would dress up as Shaggy for Halloween and exclusively speak in the Shaggy voice. And boy, was that funny for us, but not so funny for the teachers, because when you have someone going, like Scope, we got a test right now, followed by that really crappy Shaggy laugh. He would do that with that raspy and all, and pretty much make every single instructor's life an absolute pain. But it was funny, and mad respect for him. And then he took it to a whole new level, and I actually have a video of this on my phone, but he was like, hey Scope, look, it's Sans from Undertale. And then he proceeded to list off an NSFW fanfiction about all the three of them, and that's, well, jeez, I can't really, go into detail, but I had to like bleach my ears after that, because boy was that that was not okay. And I cannot state that enough times of that, just how unacceptable that fan fiction was. I mean, it would probably get a ton of points on like Rule 34 or something like that if illustrated, but my God, was that not okay. I mean, I can't begin to describe to you the absolute terror of a Sans and Shaggy and Scooby fan fiction that goes NSFW. It's absolutely terrifying. And on that note, I actually think I'm going to end this episode and leave you with those thoughts of absolute pain. Try not to use too much of your imagination, and hopefully you can get that out of your mind before. I'm trying not to laugh. I'm trying really hard not to laugh. Hopefully you can get those thoughts out of your mind before bed. And thank you for watching, and have a fantastic night. Oh, I need to get a screenshot. Hold on. Let's just go and pachow. Yes, that's